Thank you for tuning in. You're in for an educational treat. What is the most creative insult you ever heard? I held the door open for an old black woman at work one day. I am pasty white, and she looked at me dead in the eye and said "F you mayonnaise monkey" and went through the door like I was not there. I had no freaking idea if that was an insult or how I should take it, so I had to go find a black co-worker to get a ruling. He died laughing and started calling his friends on speakerphone. I am haunted to this day. Mayonnaise monkey. According to Urban Dictionary, that's an insult toward whites. So, you've gotta stop using your head as just a container for your teeth. This seems like constructive criticism to me. Not only does it have a message behind it, but it forces a not-so-bright person to figure out just what it means. On a similar note, one day my kid was standing around lost in her own world and my sister was trying to snap her out of it to go help do something. You're just gonna stand there with your teeth in your mouth or what? You're right at the top of the bell curve, aren't you? Brilliant, because it sounds like a compliment. It's not really an insult either. It's at the top of the insult slash compliment bell curve. It's a knockdown to someone who believes himself to be exceptional. You're really improving. If you keep putting in the effort, you might make it to the top of the bell curve. 16-year-old me trying to convince my dad to take my fiends and I to see American Pie. Dad, so what is it about? Me, a group of high school friends trying to lose their virginity. Dad, I can stay home and see that. How long did it take for the fire department to respond? It's a bot who stole that comment. I ain't no bot, motherfricka. Something I heard on Malcolm in the Middle, and it's seared in the back of my mind, and I will use this against someone someday. I can't wait until then. In one episode, Lois is out with her boys and their new neighbors. The neighbor kids were acting up and their mom wasn't doing anything about it, so Lois asked that mom to take care of her kids. To which that mom said, "Are you questioning my parenting?" Lois responded, "I don't know how I can, I haven't seen any. I'm just waiting to use that myself." What a show. The burns and writing were just fantastic. A quote from Firefly, "I'm guessing you weren't burdened with an overabundance of schooling." I'm mighty partial to this one, Jane, your mouth is talking. You might want to look to that. You look like the kind of person who could fail a DNA test. Or better yet, I bet you couldn't even spell DNA. I bet you need a phone book to dial 911. Was it a baseball game? Dude in the crowd yells to the batter, "I've seen better swings on a porch." I don't remember which sport I was watching, but a fellow crowd member shouted out, "If the ref had one more eye, he'd be a cyclops." Oh, that's good. I'm only 5 feet 4 inches tall. When I was a sophomore in high school, I approached this girl I liked and asked her out, and she responded with, "I wouldn't be caught dead with someone tall enough to be the guy who stands on top of a trophy. I think you dodged a bullet." She sounds like she went on to marry and divorce some guy who was glad to give up his house just to be rid of her. She sure didn't want a trophy husband. I bet when people ask your parents about you, they change the subject. That's the kind of insult you have in your arsenal but never use. I feel like if I said this to someone, I would feel compelled to follow them around, making sure they didn't harm themselves. Some guy was mocking me for looking young, so I told him I'd rather have baby face than a face that looks like smoked salmon. He got pissed, but his mate stopped him and said, "No, that's fair. No, he's got a point." Kronk. Your nose is so large you could smoke a cigarette in the shower. My brother. I heard that one on The Sopranos years ago. You're the human version of Internet Explorer. Or as heard on Community, you're the AT&T of people. Still better than Comcast. Gordon Ramsay, you're so full of crap you'd make a great politician. I love that man, Lamau. Gladys from Portal about Wethley, he's not just a regular moron. He's the product of the greatest minds of a generation working together with the express purpose of building the dumbest moron who ever lived. And you just put him in charge of the entire facility. I love Portal. I hope Valve learns to count to three. She was a lot like you, maybe not quite as heavy. I played Portal 1 and 2 for the first time this month. If you were any dumber, you would have to be watered twice a week. At least a potato can power a light bulb. I've always found the insult you're not being the person Mr. Rogers knew you could be tends to calm people down and make people reflective. No one wants to let down Mr. Rogers. What would have been your answer or question? Leave it in the comments below. Slap that like and subscribe button for more, and check out the link in the video description for even more answers. Peace out, and catch you in the next video.